Assalamualaikum, my dear children. I'm here with the 8th lesson's last part, that is around neighborhood. But before that, let's have a glance over the first part of the lesson, that is we have learned about what is neighborhood and who are neighbors and what are the places that exist in neighborhood. So what is neighborhood? Neighborhood is nothing but the places around the house is called as a neighborhood, and the people who are living in the neighborhood are the neighbors. Okay, and also we have learned about the important places that exist in neighborhood. What are the important places that will be in the neighborhood? They are nothing but the market, hospital, post office, bank, schools. These are the important places in the neighborhood. Now let's continue our discussion from here, that is we love our neighbors. So do you love your neighbors, children? Yes, we do love them, isn't it? Are you friends with your neighbors? Yes, we are friends with our neighbors. Whenever we are in need, they will help us, and whenever they need our help, we will help them, isn't it? And do we have good time together? Of course, whenever we find free time, what our parents and we do, children, we will go to our neighbor's house and we will spend good time with them by playing or chit-chatting with them, isn't it? Now here are some things that we can do to be good to our neighbors. So some things, some things are given that how you can be good to your neighbors. But before that, let's check out the HOTS. What are HOTS, children? HOTS are nothing but higher order thinking skills. Okay, so let's enhance our thinking skills. So what are some of the things in the neighborhood that should be shared by all the people? We should share our responsibility with the neighborhood, with the neighbors. What are the responsibilities like? Means by cleaning our neighborhood, by keeping our neighborhood clean and safe. Okay, and can you think of something that should not be shared? Of course, the thing that you should not share with your neighbors are the secrets. Whenever anyone tells you something important, whenever anyone shares something with you, you should not go and tell that thing with the to the other person, isn't it? By this, what will happen? People will quarrel by that. Misunderstandings will happen between them. So you should not share the secrets with your neighbors. Okay, now let's continue from here. Throw garbage in the garbage bins and do not litter the streets. So the things that we can do to be good to our neighbors is throw garbage in the garbage bins. Garbage bins, what, children? Things that we throw away are the garbage. Okay, like waste materials. After having the chips, what you will do? You will throw the chips packet where? In the garbage bin. Of course, you have to throw in the garbage bin. You should not litter here and there. Do not litter the streets means do not throw the waste here and there on the streets. You have to throw the garbage in the garbage bins only. Look at the picture here. What they are doing? They are throwing the garbage in the garbage bin so that our society will be neat and clean. The next is make sure that your parents park their cars in the proper parking place, and make sure that your parents should park the car in the proper place. You should not park here and there. Why? Because it will create disturbance in the way, isn't it? So make sure that your parents park their cars in the proper parking place. What is the meaning of park? Keep cars when they are not used is called as a park. Okay, parking. Next is play in the park and not on the streets. Of course, whenever you want to play, where you should go, children? You should go in the park only. You should not go on the streets. Why? Because while playing on the streets, what will happen if sudden one vehicle comes? They will hit you, isn't it? And you will meet with an accident. So this is not a good thing. It's a danger thing. So whenever you want to play, you should play in the park only. And use water carefully. Of course, water is a blessing from our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from our God, isn't it? So we should not waste water. Whenever you use it, use carefully. While brushing off the close the tap tightly. Okay, whenever you use it, then only you should open the tap. Okay, and do not waste water. Use water very carefully. The next is do not make loud noises or disturb others. Of course, if you, for example, look at here, old people, they will be very weak. Whenever they are at rest, you should not make loud noises and disturb others. By this, they will get disturbed, and it's not a good manner. Okay, so do not make loud noises or disturb others. Say please, sorry, and thank you when talking to your neighbors. Of course, these are the three magical words that we use while communicating, while talking with each other. So whenever required, you have to say please. If you want something from them, you should say, please, can you give me a bicycle today? isn't it? So it will look very good, isn't it? And sorry, whenever you did wrong with them, you have to say sorry for whatever I have done. So it's also a magical word. The next is thank you. Whenever anyone help you, you have to say thank you. So these are the three magical words when you have to use while talking to your neighbors. Okay. The next is, given below are some pictures. Draw a smiley next to the ones that show some ways in which we can care for our neighbors. Here are some ways that show care for our neighbors. So to you have to draw a smiley next to that, and which is not good, you have to draw a sad face. Okay. First one is helping an old man cross the street. So if any old man is there in your neighborhood, if he needs to cross the road, then you have to help them, isn't it? So it's a good thing. You have to put smiley here. Next is scribbling on cars or walls. So scribbling means what, children? Writing carelessly by using pencil, marker or anything is called as scribbling. So scribbling on cars or walls makes the car or wall look dirty, isn't it? It looks ugly, very ugly. So you should not do that. Do not scribble on cars and walls. So you have to draw a sad face here. Next is planting trees. Of course, whenever you plant a tree in your neighborhood, it will give you fresh oxygen and your society will be healthy, isn't it? So planting trees is a good thing. By this you can be a good neighbor and you can care for your neighbor by this way. So you should plant a tree wherever there is a good place to plant. Next is being rude. Being rude means talking with your neighbors in a loud noise by shouting at them. So it's not a good thing. So you can't be rude with your neighbors. What you should say while speaking with them, whenever required, say please, sorry and thank you. I told you before that, isn't it? So you should not be rude with your neighbor. So being rude is a bad thing. So you have to draw a sad face here. Okay. Now let's check out the activity here. Meet your neighbors. Find out how many people live in their house. So today what you do means you go to your neighbors and you find out how many people live in their family. Okay. And how many children do they have. Okay. And also ask them if they have any pets. Pets like if they have any dog or parrot in their house. And how is their family similar to yours? And ask also the how is your family and their family similar? Okay, same. Similar means same. How is it different from yours? And also ask how your family is different from their family. Okay. Next is neighborhood safety tips. Here are some safety tips given here. You should follow. What are those? Do not go too far away from your house alone. Yes, you are kids, children. You are very small, very young. You can't go alone far from your house. Why? Because you may forget the way back to your home and you will be in the problem, isn't it? So do not go too far away from your house alone. Whenever you go outside, you should go with your elders only. Next is do not talk to strangers. Who are strangers, children? STRANGERS. Strangers means the people whom you don't know are the strangers. So do not talk with them. Okay. Why? Because what they will do means they will kidnap you. And sometimes they will give you the chocolates and do not accept the chocolates and gifts from the strangers also. Okay. And do not talk with them. Stay away from them. Okay. Next is cross the road safely. And also whenever you need to cross the road, you should cross the road safely. How you can cross the road safely means first, for example, you are standing here and the road is here. All the vehicles are going from here. So first you have to check to the right side whether any vehicle is coming or not. Then again you have to check to the left side if any car or bike is coming or not. Then you have to again check to the right side. Then you should make sure that no vehicle is coming. Then only you should cross the road. And of course you should cross the road with your adult only. Okay, do not cross alone. You may meet with an accident or spill. Okay, so you should be very careful while crossing the road. So in this lesson we have learned about how we should be good to our neighbors and how and what are the important places in the neighborhood. Okay. Hope you people will be good today, good with your neighbors from now onwards, and you should maintain your neighborhood very cleanly. Okay. Now this was our end of the 8th lesson, and we'll catch up in the next video with the new lesson. Till then, stay safe, stay connected. Allah Hafiz.